We're going to find the cross product of these two vectors, v equals 3, 7, 2, and u equals 1, 2, 3. Since we're going to do v cross u, we put v first, so the 3, 7, 2 is above the 1, 2, 3. And we're going to do this in three pieces. The first thing we need to do is find the I piece.
And for the I piece, we're going to take just the part of this matrix that doesn't involve the row or column that I is in. So if we cross out the row and column I is in, that leaves us with 7, 2, 2, 3. And then we can erase those lines. And we need the J component. So for the J component, we're going to do the same thing. We're going to cross out the row and column that J's in. And that leaves us with 3, 2, 1, 3. And then we're going to do the same thing for the K component. So we'll cross out the row and column that K is in. And we'll have the K component being 3, 7, 1, 2. So now if you've done determinants of 2 by 2 matrices before, what we're going to do with each of these blocks will look familiar. But what we want to do is multiply diagonally down and then diagonally down the other way. First one we're going to add, the second one we're going to subtract. So we're going to have the I component 7 times 3 minus 2 times 2. Minus, let's do this again with J, we have 3 times 3 minus 2 times 1. And then with K, we have 3 times 2 minus 7 times 1. And then we can simplify that a little bit. So 21 minus 4, so 17. I minus 9 minus 2, so 7J plus 6 minus 7, so minus. Okay. And remember, we could also rewrite that as 17 comma minus 7 comma minus 1 if you like that notation better. All right, now we're going to find the vector-valued function for the line which passes through the points 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6. Now we have a formula if we have a point and a direction. That's kind of like our point-slope formula of a line for regular lines. But we don't have a direction here. We have two points. So how are we going to find a direction? Well, what we're going to do is, if you think about this, if we think about those points as vectors, say this was 1, 2, 3, and this was 4, 5, 6. So those are the two points on our line. If we think of them as vectors, and we subtract them, then we're going to get a vector in the direction of our line. So we find a new vector, which is 1, 2, 3, minus 4, 5, 6. And it doesn't really matter which order you're going to do this in, because either way the vector is on your line. So this would be negative 3, negative 3, negative 3. I maybe should have done it the other way just so it was positive, but it doesn't matter. And then we can put it into our formula. So we get x, y, z is equal to, pick one of your points, 1, 2, 3, plus t times the vector negative 3, negative 3, negative 3. All right, now we are asked to find the values where the following vector-valued function is not continuous. So a vector value function is not continuous where any of its components are not continuous. So e to the t is always continuous, so that's not a problem. 5 over t minus 3 will not be continuous where the bottom is equal to 0. So that would be when t equals 3. It's not continuous. And then tangent, remember tangent is really sine over cosine. So tangent is not continuous whenever cosine is equal to 0. And remember, that's going to be t equals pi over 2 plus k pi. So you put these all together, and that's all the points where your vector-valued function is not continuous. Here we're asked to describe the way that this parametric equation is going to look. So this is a parametric equation, x equals 3 plus 2 cosine of t, and y equals 4 plus 2 sine of t, and z equals 2t, and t is going from 0 to 6. And it gives us a hint here that we should remember that a circle in the xy plane with a radius a centered at x naught, y naught, is given by this formula right here. And we can notice right away that our x and y coordinates match this formula. So if we're looking in just the xy plane, we should have a circle centered at 3, 4. So there's our center with a radius of 2. In just the xy plane, it looks like this. And which direction is it going? That's a good question. So it says if v is positive, it's going clockwise. So it's going to go this way. And what's more, we have values for t. So t starts at 0 and goes to pi over 6. So when t equals 0, x equals 3 plus 2. And y equals 4. So we're starting right here when t equals 0, and we're going around. We're going to get back to this point again when t equals 2 pi, and again when t equals 4 pi, and then when t equals 6 pi. So we're going to go around the circle once to 2 pi, second time to 4 pi, a third time to 6 pi. So 3 times around clockwise. All right, so that makes sense. But what does the z do? So z is 2t. So that means that t equals 0, 0, 0. And then it's progressively getting bigger and bigger and bigger until it gets to 12 pi. So what is 12 pi? Well, it's pi is about 3, right? So 36 or 40. All right, so what does this mean in our 3D space? So here's our x, y, z. And so we have x being 3, y being 4 is our center. So projected down here, we have a radius of 2. So this is what it looks like projected down. But now let's switch colors so that we can really see where we start. We started, remember, with x equals 5 and y equals 4. So x equals 5, y equals 4 was right here. And now that's z equals 0, so that is in the xy plane. But now we're going to go around clockwise, and z is going to get progressively bigger. So this is a spiral that's over top of that circle. Not very good at this. And it goes around 3 times. And this is at a height of 12 pi. Z equals 12 pi when we stop, and it should be directly over this point down here. And that's what it looks like.